Yes, we are live. Good morning to one and all present here. Yeah, before beginning our webinar, I would like to mention the few points. The quiz will be conducted at the end of the session, where you will get a chance to win the AWS credits. So stay tuned till the end of the session. The question and answer round will be conducted in the last 15 minutes, where you will ask the questions from the guest speaker itself, and the guest speaker will try to answer all the queries. So we are beginning with the webinar. A very warm good morning to honorable speaker and the member of the AWS and all the attendees out there. I, Vitesh Sethi, co-organizer of AWS User Group Dehradun and events team member of UPES Cloud Security Alliance, would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you in the webinar entitled AWS Trainings and Certifications organized by UPES Cloud Security Alliance and AWS User Group Dehradun. Now, let me introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Saurabh Bhattacharya. Mr. Saurabh Bhattacharya is a senior technical trainer at Amazon Internet Services Private Limited, AISPL. He is an AWS and VMware expert with AAI and VCI certifications under belt. His other certifications include AWS Solutions Architect Associate, Database Specialty, and AWS Big Data Specialty certifications, VCI Level 2, VCAP 5, DCA, VCP 456, and many more. He has overall 16 years of industry experience in both India and abroad. He worked as hardware support, network administrator, team lead, pre-sales consultant, and technical advisor, sales and BDM, technology evangelist, technical manager, senior technical instructor. His hobbies include music, sports, and traveling both in India and abroad, and also he traveled five continents extensively. Now, over to you, sir.
Hey, thank you, Vitesh, and good morning, everyone. Really glad you all could join on a weekend, but I would love to spend this next 1 hour with all of you to educate about AWS training and certifications and what all programs do we have, what all resources do we have, which all of you could use for your pursual, all right? And this 1 hour session, we will try to address your queries. And after that, there'll be a quiz as well. And stay tuned to redeem some credits, all right? So let's get started. So my name is Saurabh, you all know me. And I'm sharing my LinkedIn handle as well as my email address at the bottom of the screen. So anytime you would like to get in touch with me, please do so. Anywhere I can help you all, that'll be my greatest pleasures. Overall now, around 17 plus years of experience, which I possess and have wore multiple hats during my tenure. And traveling is by far my biggest hobby. And in this new normal, nobody's traveling. So I'm not an exception as well. But yes, before this pandemic began, I used to travel quite extensively. Have covered around 64, 65 countries in this world. And in some of those countries, many, many, many times. And I've made a lot of friends. And I'm hoping to make a few friends out of you folks as well. So let's get started. And what I'll do is I'll probably go ahead and switch off my camera so that you can focus on the presentation, right? So when we look at, the cloud skills gap, right? This is one of the most important things because a lot of people, as the cloud technologies, they continue to help organizations to transform their businesses. It is happening at a very rapid pace, all right? Employees with the necessary cloud skills are really high in demand. And a survey from 451 Research shows that 90% of IT decision makers, they report the cloud skills shortage, right? So just think about it. 90% is a huge number, right? And one of the most effective ways you can close this skill gap is by educating and leveraging your existing knowledge, right? So AWS training and certification offers the resources which you need to develop yourselves and your teams as well to innovate in the cloud and transform the complete organization as well along with it. Because some of you might be working in some company, some of you might be students, some of you might be looking out for a job. So we offer a range of resources which are developed and updated regularly by the experts at AWS to help you educate yourself and achieve your cloud goals. And today I'll talk through why it's important to invest in educating yourself and also give you an overview of our programs and offerings to help you unlock the power of AWS Cloud. All right. So I hope you are as excited as me as to go through this program. And let's talk through why this matters for yourself and what we offer in more detail. So we have a large number of programs, all right, to help you get more out of the cloud. And we can combine our offerings to help you craft a very comprehensive training program to close the cloud skills gap. The first thing which we do, we offer a library of free digital training courses, which allows your team to learn on demand. So this is like the learn on demand kind of a thing, self-paced kind of trainings, which you could go through at your own pace, all right? Which is the most important thing. And you know, next, of the most effective ways to train your staff is through the classroom training as well. So expert instructors can teach your teams, to be in a immersive, hands-on, kind of program. And then hands-on is something which everybody needs, isn't it? Because once you do the labs and once you deal with those services with your own hands, it basically increases your confidence as well. Right. And in addition to the programs which you saw now, digital training and classroom trainings, our AWS certification program, it helps you benchmark your existing knowledge and skills and also helps you to identify, these skilled professionals during the, for the companies during the hiring process as well. So it's pretty important. A lot of job openings, which I do see, in the cloud, I do see a lot of them. They basically are asking for, certified candidates, right? This is your big ticket to at least get your resumes shortlisted, because that's the first step. If your resumes are not getting shortlisted, I don't think we will be able to think about the whole interview process and the experience, right? And finally, we are also committed to helping our customers to close their skills gap by a lot of education programs as well, all right? So let's take a closer look at each one of them. All right. So digital training, this is something which, as I mentioned, it's absolutely free of cost as of now. And you can just register yourself and you can pursue the contents which are like ever growing. Every week, I do see some new contents which are available. And the easiest URL which you can remember is aws.training. Once you go to that aws.training, you will find a learning library. And once you go to the learning library, you will find the digital trainings. And these digital trainings are absolutely free as of now, and you can go through it. Some of these trainings, I'll just probably show you a sample. So these are some of these sample courses. Now, what one thing you need to understand is some of these trainings are kind of micro trainings where they might be like 5 minutes to 10 minutes in length, and then will tell you a very basic idea about some of the things, right? And some of these trainings, they are e-learnings and curriculums, which might go into several hours as well. So imagine that any latest technology which you want to learn, and it could be anything. I mean, think about the most happening technologies in the world today. As per my knowledge, are machine learning and blockchain and IoT and big data. So all these technologies. There are many, many of you who might not, been exposed to some of these technologies, right? For example, IoT. If you go ahead and ask people, and I do interview a lot in Amazon, people who apply for this particular AWS interviews, I do interview them. And then one of the questions which if I ask them, like, okay, have you heard about IoT? And the most likely the answer will be, yes, we have heard about it. And then you ask them, what is IoT? And they'll say Internet of Things. And if you ask them, okay, that's the full form, but what is IoT? And then the last thing they will talk about is sensors, something to do with devices and sensors. The problem is, this is like the half-cooked or half-baked knowledge. And I don't think with this knowledge, we'll be able to, cross through the interview process. So the most important thing which we need to understand is, what is IoT, in detail? What is this, machine learning and AI and deep learning people are talking about? And then, generally the questions might not be just like, okay, what is machine learning? Some of them might ask you a question, something like, do you know what all about the ensemble algorithms? And I'm not sure how many of you have read today's morning Times of India, but then I was just reading the front page headline is about the IMD, which is the Meteorological Department, which basically provides us the weather forecasting. And you know, there is a bullet point, as a headline, which says that they are using a lot of ensemble mechanisms, right? So what is this ensemble mechanisms? It's like a mix of multiple algorithms, right, for you to be able to predict something. And with that, the IMD claims that they'll be able to predict the most accurate state-by-state, results from the weather forecasting system and stuff like that. Now, the thing is, if somebody asks you what is machine learning, maybe you'll be able to answer it. But then, are you really comfortable about talking about ensemble algorithms? Are you comfortable to talk about classification or regression kind of problems, right? And then the same thing holds true for anything. So this free digital training is one-stop shop for you. Right now, it's free of cost. Just go ahead and register yourself. And this is just a sample which I'm trying to show you. You can view the full library at aws.training. Again, I'm repeating the path. It's aws.training portal. Go to a learning library and then go to digital training. All right. And that's where you'll find close to 500 plus of these courses. Okay. Apart from that, some of the learners, they prefer a classroom training. Now, there could be multiple reasons. If you ask me, I'm a person who would love to, have someone teach me something, because this is how I learn stuff fast, right? And the good thing is I can do that with a video training or an online training as well, but then I will not be able to ask a question. And the thing is, I know over the internet, I can go ahead and search the answer of any questions which I have. But then how many of us seriously consider doing that? Every single time I have a question, I go to internet and try to search it. Because a lot of you need to have that inquisitive, minds where you are able to, learn stuff by being really, really curious, right? And then how many of us can be always have in that learn and be curious mind frame? And that's a big question. So for me, I would prefer to undergo a in-person training where somebody is teaching me, and at the same time, if I have a question, I can go ahead and ask, right? So for those learners, we do have in-person virtual trainings as well from the instructors. Virtual now because of the pandemic, we are all working from homes, but we use a variety of mechanisms and methods to teach and reinforce the skills during the classroom trainings. And that's one part of my job which I do in Amazon. This is my fourth year, and I'm a senior technical instructor, and we try to engage our audience, right? We break down and explain the complex topics, and hands-on lab reinforces what we have learned, in-depth group discussions around specific challenges and opportunities. They all lead to greater understanding kind of a thing, right? So when we craft a classroom training, right, we align it to the IT world. We align it to the IT business. We talk about the relevant industry use cases, right? Which ensures that the right training, it reaches to the right people, and then it makes it more efficient. So we do have 20 plus courses with variety of roles and levels. Feel free, the same place where you will find the digital trainings, you will find a tab for classroom trainings as well. So I'll just show you a sample. So this is kind of a sample of classroom training courses, but we have around 20 of them. Right. And we, have it in three modalities. So if let's say there is a whole company, right, or it could be a college, it could be an institution. And if they come to us and they say that, hey, we have a group of people and they want to undergo the training, we can conduct the virtual private trainings for them. Right. And again, this is something usually used to happen in person and then in a physical classroom kind of a thing. But then now in the new normal, more or less, it has converted into virtual private trainings. So here, there are two benefits. One, you can attend the training at the comfort of your homes, all right? And two, if for a company as well, if you think about it, they might have employees in multiple cities or maybe different geographies, right? And then for them, they can actually collaborate all those employees in a single training, right? So that's the benefit of the virtual training, and then you are at your convenience. But then we do conduct a few public training classes as well. This is for individual, individuals or individual learners who can register and they can go through it, right? And the good thing is, if you look at it, here are some of the quotes from our customers who have invested in training for their employees, and the results they have been able to see is phenomenal. If you can read, what Alan Williams had to talk about or think about the Peter's quote over here from Siemens, and you would come to know the keywords which I've highlighted: less outages, costs are going down, getting leaner, speed up the innovation process. These are some of the side effects, of a learned, colleague of or a learned employee for any organization. And this is what the organizations are looking for. All right. So AWS certifications, they are highly, rated and sought after industry recognized credentials. When organizations support their staff in earning them, it can have numerous benefits, right? Certifications can definitely drive the innovations. And according to a study by, the Enterprise Strategy Group or ESG, 91% of organizations that employ AWS certified staff, they say that AWS certification gives their staff the ability to identify and different ways to take advantage of AWS services, which is quite phenomenal. And then AWS certifications can definitely drive the operational benefits like increased productivity, because 90% of the IT leaders at organizations with AWS certified staff, they say that having that staff increases their productivity. And the best thing is certifications and the organizations who basically promote them, it can definitely improve the recruiting and the, the retention of their employees as well, right? Because 93% of the organizations, they say supporting AWS certifications improves recruitment, and 96% agree that their decision to certify cloud-focused staff on AWS has improved their retention as well. So IT decision makers who employ these certified staff, they feel quite confident in the value of supporting their teams in earning those certifications. And 97%, they say that it puts their company in a better competitive position to succeed over in the next 3 to 5 years, right? And pretty important facts which you need to consider when we talk about these certifications. So today, if you look at it, we have a lot of certifications, and we have these certifications at 4 different levels, all right? So we have the foundational level, where this is for anyone, whether you are a technical person or a non-technical person, and you would like to go through the cloud concepts or the basics, then cloud practitioner certification is something which can be taken up, right? And again, this is a certification we have, we are seeing in the industry. A lot of senior managers, a lot of, non-technical people, they are also going through this certification. Now, imagine that you would like to, showcase your, technical talent kind of a thing. And for that, we have 3 more categories of these certifications. We have the associate level, we have the professional level, and we do have a specialty level as well. And you know what is the most important thing which you need to know? There is no prerequisite for you for writing any of these certifications. And you can write any certifications in any order. So if, let's say, you are confident and you are working on AWS Cloud for quite some time now, and you understand all the concepts, you can directly write any professional or any specialty certification directly without writing any other prior certifications if you want. Isn't that amazing? So these are some of the things which we have done for our learners, which differentiate us and which also gives that freedom of choice in the hands of the learners, how they would like to go through it. So if you want to know more about these AWS certifications, you can visit the aws.amazon.com/certification portal. And that's where you'll be able to get to see all these certifications which are available. You'll be able to see their exam blueprints, how many questions are asked, what is the time period, what is the fees, and everything. All right. So that's one good thing which you can do. Now, the good thing is, if you look at it, what we are trying to do, what's our goal? Our goal is to prepare these diverse learners for open roles in the cloud industry, right? So we have a lot of education programs as well, which works with higher education institutions, programs like AWS Educate, AWS Academy. We have SkillsGate, we have Restart, we have Reskill. A lot of these programs, they basically, are aimed at these learners, right? And then, if you would like to go through, some of these programs, you can just search for AWS educational programs on internet, and you'll be able to get to all these different programs which are in the offering. So recently, I'm not sure how many of you have heard about National Australian Bank or NAB. So this is just like SBI of India in Australia, but on a much bigger scale. And NAB, they invested in a comprehensive training program for their organizations. And here's what the chief of the technology and operations officer said about their goals when they started out. So NAB is one of the Australia's four major banks and the largest business bank with more than 30,000 employees as of now, right? And 9 million customers across 900 locations. And this is an example of a customer who had a lot of success incorporating all of our educational resources together for their people. So I just want you to focus on the outcomes, the right-hand side section, because as NAB, they embarked on their AWS journey, they had several goals, all right? And then which included using AWS technology to not only accelerate their business, but they realized that they need to be more agile, they need to increase the frequency, the efficiency, and make their systems more resilient as well. And to do this, they needed their employees to have excellent AWS skills, which required a good, great training programs, right? And then that is what, they actually went ahead and created a Skilled Guild program. And then this Skilled Guild actually is a series of training and enablement programs for their employees, right? And the outcomes is in front of you. So organizations across the globe, they are seeking individuals who are skilled in transformative technologies of the cloud, right? And to meet this growing demand, for the developers of today and tomorrow, or the experts or even the novices, right, of today and tomorrow, we have a lot of programs and offerings from the TNC perspective. So TNC stands for training and certification. And we do have made a 2025 skills commitment as well. And you know what this skills commitment is? And I'm not sure how many of you have heard about this skills commitment from Amazon, but Amazon will help 29 million people around the world to build these cloud skills with free training by 2025. And why is so? Why we had to go ahead and make this commitment is because there aren't enough, cloud computing professionals to meet the growing demand. I'm not sure how many of you keep, your tips on the trends which are happening in the industry, but I would highly encourage you all, whenever you get time, to go ahead and look at it, what is the cloud skill shortage in the industry? And you will realize what I'm talking about, right? And then to help bridge this skills gap, Amazon is investing hundreds of millions of dollars to provide this free cloud computing skills training to people from all backgrounds in more than 200 countries and territories. And then Amazon is giving all individuals, from those who are just getting started to even the most experienced professionals, all right? So one thing which you and then your friends and then your family and anyone who is interested in building their career or making their career in cloud is to access these trainings, right? There are digital trainings which I've already told you about. There are many training events which we conduct as part of our commitment to evangelize the cloud skills in the market. And you could go ahead and learn from each of these kind of trainings which are available. We conduct a lot of awesome days. We conduct different industry vertical days. We conduct a lot of service line days, like machine learning specialty day and stuff like that. And then including the exam readiness events as well. I think just yesterday I had delivered one exam readiness session for more than 500-600 people, right? And then And these are some of the trainings which are absolutely free, and we conduct them as part of the events. And you can just go online and find out our events calendar, register yourself. It's absolutely free. And then take advantage of all these things, right? And then there are a lot of, you know, platforms which basically we use it to spread, you know, all these particular, you know, training programs. So if you look at it through programs like Restart and Educate, we prepare diverse learners for entry-level cloud roles around the world. With hands-on experience on AWS, our graduates have skills and knowledge they need to add value on their job when they get hired. So AWS Restart, it basically teaches AWS cloud fundamentals to help people succeed in entry-level cloud positions. And whereas AWS Educate is Amazon's global initiative to provide students the comprehensive resources to build skills in this cloud technology and accelerate their cloud learning and prepare students for the cloud-enabled jobs for tomorrow. And this cloud skills gap is absolutely real. And if you look at it, this is, you know, from the Digital Transformation is About Talent and Not Technology, is an article from Harvard Business Review last year. And as for them, your ability to adapt to an even more digital future depends on developing the next generation of cloud skills, which means closing the gap between the talent supply and the demand. And as cloud migration has accelerated, so has the demand for the cloud talent as well. You know, I'll share one fact with all of you. I do go ahead and meet a lot of customers. I have met a lot of customers. I work with a lot of customers. And, you know, whether you believe it or not, there were still, you know, some customers who used to say, or some friends of mine who used to say that, hey, you know what, cloud is great, but then we are happy. We are happy in our physical data centers, which is good enough reasons. They might have their own reasons for them. You know that? Then pandemic strike. Now, the question is, again, I believe every one of us in the world, some way or the other, might have got, you know, touched with this pandemic. And you look at the IT industry, the landscape of IT, and you will realize that when the lockdowns did start last year, you know, a lot of people, they were really in a messy state. Why? Because you can't expect your IT professionals to go to their data centers to maintain and manage their data centers because there is a lockdown, you know. You can't expect them to stay within the company premises or within the data centers. That's too harsh. And believe me or not, this is something which has propelled, you know, the cloud migrations all over the world, all over the world. And then, if you know, you know, pandemic is really bad, and we all do understand it, we all do acknowledge it. But then there is a silver lining which, you know, the IT industry is seeing, which is the constant accelerated shift towards the cloud. And then this is something which is happening. And that is because of which the cloud skill gap is coming up, right? And this is persisting because according to a 2020 survey conducted by Global Knowledge, 78% of global IT managers, they reported the skills gaps in their organizations, and only 1% lower from the 2019's data. Just imagine. And furthermore, 68% of IT decision makers, they anticipate the new skills gaps in the next 2 years. And of the many factors that impact the skills gap, IT decision makers say the primary drivers are the rate of technology changes, which are outpacing the skill development training programs, and then difficulties attracting the candidates with the right skills. And of the many factors that impact the cloud skills, you know, the primary driver is outpacing, you know, the technological growth towards the skills which people are developing over a period of time. That's pretty phenomenal. And that is one thing which can be a silver lining for you, each one of you. If you think about it, technology is changing pretty fast, right? And then there are many people who are just starting off with the cloud, right? The question is, cloud is not something where, you know, you have to strictly follow a script. It's not something where I need to first learn the alphabets, and then I need to learn the words, and I need to form the sentences, and only then I'll be able to write the paragraph. That's one misconception. Definitely, the basics is something we should be, you know, thriving for. And if we have a great foundation, then it basically accelerates our learning platform, right? We all do understand that. But then the good news is, because all these services, if you look at it at AWS as well, there are 7,000 around services and features which exist, today. And if you look at all these services and features, do you think there will be, you know, a few people who are expert in all these services and features? I don't think so. At least I'm not. And I'm one of the technical folks in the company. And I can assure you that every person has certain forte, you know, they have certain topics, certain services, which they are master at. And then once they do become master of one or two things, then they try to expand their breadth. You know, so they try to add more and more services under their forte, and then they become slowly become masters of these, right? So this is one easiest way where you can create your own edge. Because if you remember the specialty certifications I talked about, right, you don't have to be really from a cloud background. You might be interested in, let's say, machine learning, for example, right? And then, or maybe big data technologies, or maybe IoT, and maybe, you know, anything you talk about. But using that technology on the cloud, even if you start with that step, right? So you are definitely not starting with the alphabets here, because you're already interested in some technology and you're just trying to browse through your ways and trying to research about, okay, let's say I'm good at machine learning, but then how I can take it to the cloud? Because this difference is the gap which exists in the industry today. People, organizations, they have people who are expert. They're expert in their own line. Maybe they're expert in security. But then the question is how you would take that expertise and then map it with the cloud, right? That's the most important thing which people are, you know, missing. And that's where you can have that edge across all over the globe. Because one good news which I can share with you is one of the things which I'm noticing now is that boundaries are getting dissolved, which means earlier, let's say I am right now based out of Hyderabad. That's where I stay with my family. And let's say if I have to look out for a job, I'd be looking at companies in Hyderabad, maybe, right? Because relocation is a big pain. We all do understand that. But then again, if you look at myself, let's say 17 years ago when I was a fresher, and then you would have been asking this question to me, I would have been open. I would say that I can go and work at any place, you know, in this world, as long as I'm getting a good job and I'm getting a good paycheck, right? The good news is, because of all these virtual work from home, one more culture which has already started in advanced countries is to hire from anywhere. And this is one of the initiatives which a lot of companies are starting. And trust me, it'll be rapidly expanding as well in due course and time. And again, the good thing which everybody came to know about is that companies are still running. I know a lot of companies are struggling, but then the work is still running in most of the companies. And at least that work is something which can run from home, right? And that is something which could be an edge which you can build for yourself, right? So again, IDC Futurescape, the research, it predicts the gap will continue. So an estimated 30% of global IT jobs will be left open by 2022 as employers compete for workers with those skills, right? And that is the most important thing which we need to understand. This is an opportunity in disguise, whether you believe it or not. But I would really encourage all of you to don't miss this bus. This is a bus which is going for sure, and don't miss this bus. You still have time. And cloud computing is the number one hard skills that companies need. Let me show you this ESG data in detail. So, you know, as part of the study which is being done by the ESG, they included a broad range of AWS customers across varying geographies, company sizes, industries, and participants. They comprised of, you know, senior level executives, including the managers, with 74% respondents were VPs and C-suite and director level members. And through this exercise, ESG evaluated the impact of employing the AWS certified employees, right, compared to those organizations without AWS certified staff. So the study found out that supporting staff in earning an AWS certification can drive numerous operational benefits as well. It can help teams increase productivity, accelerate the project completion, and troubleshoot faster. And it can improve the cloud security in general as well, which is job zero for many organizations, including Amazon. And according to the study of ESG, 86% of IT decision makers that employ AWS certified staff, they say that doing so improved the security posture of their cloud workloads. Right. And the study also shows that 87% of the organizations that employ these certified staff, they have reduced the downtime, and they have achieved faster deployment times. And supporting staff in certifications, these companies are realizing these benefits, right? So 90%, they say, having certified staff helped them to innovate faster. So now I'm talking about companies, and you might be wondering why he's talking about companies. The thing is, on the other side of it is you. Whom these companies are going to hire? They are looking for these people, and it could be you, right? So that is something which we need to ensure that we equip ourselves to achieve at that level. I'll share something for you, okay, in very simple layman terms. When I was, at your level, I used to dream pretty big. I still dream, quite big. But then my dreams, the level of my dreams at that level, at that age, was really, at a very low scale, I would say, right now, if I compare it as of today. And I used to think that, hey, I need to get, this much salary package at least, because this is what the friends are getting. I need to get a job in this company, in that company. And then the problem was, now after having all these years of experience, I have realized that there was one challenge which people do face with. And the challenge is, they only look at one side of the coin. They don't look at the other side of the coin. The other side of the coin is, are we ready for that? That's a big question. So, it's something like, are we deserving for that or not? And there is one quote which I have learned from one of my ex-managers. And the quote is, he always used to say this, deserve before you desire. And that's a pretty solid quote if you ask me. Deserve before you desire anything, which means you can think big, you can have big dreams, but then are we deserving? So we need to ensure that we work backwards, we make ourselves equipped, and we become deserving. And then you have a free hand to desire whatever you want, right? So, these certifications, they can really help in recruitments, and they can also help retention as well for the companies as well. So it's both sides of the coin for the employee. It's like, increasing their morale, increasing their, the confidence levels and increasing their knowledge and everything. But just remember one thing, folks, do it the right way. And that's the most important thing. People who follow a lot of shortcuts in their lives, I think it's a very short-term strategy, and you will never find those people in the long run being successful. Read stories of any successful people whom you have heard about, and you will find one great thing about all of them, which is common. And the thing is, they do the right thing the hard way. And that is the most important thing. There is no shortcuts for success. There is no shortcut for hard work or determination or your devotion or your dedication. So that is one thing which I would like to leave you all with, because that's the most important thing. And, more certified people, it matters to companies. It not only helps them to see greater advantages and benefits for less, but it also, drive more innovation and more revenue or more top line and bottom line for these customers as well. So that's the most important thing. A lot of studies have happened around in this area. One of them was with the global knowledge data as well, which I would like to show you. The IT leaders are investing in training to close the skills gap, because they do realize it. And in fact, last year, Global Knowledge conducted the survey, which reports that when these decision makers are asked about how will they attempt to close the skills gap, 56% of them, they responded with training of their staff, right? And 80% of these decision makers, they approved the formal training when it was authorized by the company, right? So that is the most important thing. You need to understand that. Again, you will find, you know, informal trainings as well, many places. But then just check with those people who might have gone through those informal trainings. If any training has benefited them, please go ahead and pursue it. But then more often than not, what I have noticed is these informal trainings, are again one way of shortcuts. And again, you need to judge whether it is helping you or not. So it might seem pretty, easy going for you, and you might realize that, yes, probably this is something from where I can, you know, build up my entire dreams and, you know, everything. But then again, validate it and only then go for it. So formal training is the key word. When you have a lot of free trainings which are available at a formal level, why not go through them, right? That's something which you all can do. And as a result of these upskilling, there are a lot of business benefits as well. Again, why I'm showing you this is because you need to know why you need to equip yourself, because this is what the other side of the coin is looking at you. The businesses are looking at those candidates who are not only skilled, they are qualified, they have validated their skills with certifications, and they can bring value or add value to their organization and their, you know, companies. So I'll just take one example of machine learning, because most of you might be coming from that background of developing, and if I take machine learning, right? There are a lot of these courses which are available for machine learning experts or even the novices who are just getting started with machine learning. Not sure how many of you have heard about our machine learning university, but that's one thing you need to look at it. We have a lot of these free courses which are there in digital learning library. You will find a lot of them, a lot of other assets which we have. All you have to do is just search. And we do have these trainings as well. We do have a 4-day training of machine learning pipeline on AWS, where we teach machine learning from scratch to be able to equip you with that knowledge which is required to be able to independently create your own machine learning models and getting predictions out of it. So that's something which is pretty important. And for all our courses, we have something which we call it as RUG. RUG stands for ramp up guides, right? So these ramp up guides are, you know, available. And if you open these ramp up guides, just search it on internet, you will find it. These ramp up guide, they basically tell you from 0 to 100, what is this path which you have to follow. Step by step procedures are there. There are, you know, white papers available, the free videos available. All these things are available as part of that RUG. So just download these RUGs and then, you know, go through it on your own way. The good thing is everything is formal here. So any documentation which is available, white papers which are available, any e-learning which is available, everything is formal. Everything has been created by AWS. So directly drink from the horse's mouth, right? That's the keyword. And about the certification, how one should create their journey for the certification, there are a few steps, right? And the best preparation of certification is via practical experience. But we also offer a range of resources to help candidates prepare their exams. And some of these resources you can see over here. And this is the step with which you have to go through, right? And the good thing is any certification which you achieve, there is a recertification every 3 years, which means that certification will be valid for 3 years. And after that, you will have to go through the recertification as well. Why? Because the pace at which the innovation is happening, you will become obsolete after that. So you got to validate your skill every 3 years. Right. And what you get in return, you get the digital badges, which you can showcase on your LinkedIn handles or wherever you need. Right. And the good news is, since last year, since the pandemic began, we have started the online proctoring as well, which means to write these AWS certifications, you don't have to go outside your house. You can proctor these exams directly at the comfort of your homes. And that is the best thing which you can think about. So this online proctoring is available when you book your exams or certifications. Just choose home proctoring and that will do the job for you. You can book anytime which is convenient for you, and you can write the certification at the comfort of your home. Right. So that is one good news which has happened. And, you know, the certified population is growing. So don't miss this bus. This is the data of August 2020 last year. And we are seeing this community growing like anything. We had over 400,000 individuals who were holding active AWS certifications as of August 2020. And this number, which grew more than 85% between the last year. So just think about it. The growth rate of these certifications were over 85%. So just, I'm just waiting to see this August what that number would be, right? And we do have another program, which is AWS Academy as well. So again, AWS Academy is something which comprises of the authorized curriculum, which is developed and maintained by AWS, which is a way for institutions or your schools and colleges to even keep pace with the industry development, right? One of the big problems which the industry says that there is a huge gap between what is being taught in the colleges and then what we require in the industry, right? So programs like AWS Academy is trying to bridge that kind of a knowledge gap. So there are curriculums which are designed to be integrated into accredited degree, diploma, and continuing or professional education programs. And again, the course content is uniquely considered, of higher educational format, and content is designed to be consumed over a long period of time in smaller, hands-on approach kind of a thing. So it is aligned with the students who are preparing for AWS certifications as well. So that's one thing which you can do. And thanks in large part to the work of these and the other educators around the world, AWS Academy is building a pipeline of graduates with strong AWS skills who are ready to join the 21st century workforce. So if you are looking for new cloud talent, and this is a message which we give to each company, that if they need new talent of AWS certified people or knowledgeable people, they can visit our AWS Academy website. And from there, they can go ahead and source the people directly out of these institutional educational institutes, right? And again, Academy offers a number of different courses and learning resources, which are all aligned towards certification. And these are some of the courses, as you can see. And the graduates are a diverse set of individuals located in different cities and towns all around the world. And some of the employers who hire from AWS Academy, some of them are mentioned in front of you. So here you are seeing just a few of those customers, but then we have seen Academy graduates go on to get jobs in various industries and in various roles, like a solution architect, a DevOps professional, system engineers, business analyst, and cloud consultants. We talked about one more program, which was Restart. So again, the Restart trains a diverse set of learners for entry-level cloud positions, as I mentioned, and it connects alumni with local employers. So Restart focuses on preparing unemployed and underemployed individuals for those entry-level cloud positions. And in addition, it helps customers address the entry-level cloud skill gaps by building a more diverse and inclusive workforce. So Restart is a free, full-time, classroom-based development and training program that prepares non-traditional learners for entry-level cloud positions. So after 12 weeks of training, which is like 3 months, the Restart connects alumni with potential employers, and the learners are supported by professional mentors and accredited trainers, and complete their cloud training, which is based on learnings and hands-on labs and courseworks. All these things, including the real-world scenario-based exercises and labs, and jams and a lot of troubleshooting stuffs and all these things, right? So again, get involved and get connected with all these graduates. And again, you can, if you are interested in, you can make a, note of an email address, which is aws-restart-employers@amazon.com. Right? So this is something which, would be a great thing which can be used, right? And a lot of, cities and locations all over the world, this is happening. So if you look at it, when we started off with this program, the goal was for anyone who would like to start their journey in cloud can consume it. But then with each cohort, we understood that just by training them might not, go a long way. We need to get them employed, and we need to provide them the required mentoring and coaching. And we need to create that path for them so that from start to finish, we can actually do the hand holding and they can become successful. And we have a lot of digital partners as well. Some of these digital partners as well from where you can go ahead and consume AWS courses. And I'll just show you the sample of it, right? This is like the sample, but then you can go ahead and search on these platforms. A lot of the courses are being created by AWS employees itself. So a lot of additional customer codes and examples you can see. I'll not go through each one of them, but I'll just read out the highlighted part for you. Delivering new services and new opportunities, progress would have been much slower if wouldn't have been for AWS training, more innovative, reduce the time it takes to innovation, a new paradigm. TUI is an Anglo-German, multinational travel and tourism company, which is headquartered in Hanover, Germany. And it is the largest leisure and travel and tourism company in the world. And it owns the travel agencies, hotels, airlines, cruise ships, and retail stores as well. And just look at their outcomes, right? Similarly, I'm showing you for Kmart as well, which is the front runner in discount department stores in Australia with 228 retail stores, more than 30,000 employees and annual sales of the region crossing across $600 million, right? This is about the Kmart. Siemens is a well-known name. They wanted to establish a cloud offering and develop a cloud positive culture in their organization. So they also partnered with us, to educate both broader team and the key technical teams as well. Capital One, again, wanted to migrate more quickly to the cloud. 1,400 students trained across the globe from Capital One and increased their production applications from 10 to 100 plus in less than a year. Similarly, this is about GE. So I'm just showing you some use cases of our customers who are leveraging these trainings and who are looking for a lot of AWS trained professionals, right? And this is one, Intuit is another one. So the thing which we need to understand is there are a lot of, learning paths which we have. So we have role-based trainings. We have, solution areas. We have a lot of AWS partners as well, if you are from one of them. You can, just go through any one of the roles, either, it is cloud practitioner role or architect role or developer role, operations role, or even DevOps role. Or you can go into solution areas as well. You can pick out any hot technology if you want, right? So I believe that's where I'll take a pause and I'll stop and I will leave it up to you folks to go ahead and ask any questions if you have. I think that is something which we can do it now. Any questions, any doubts, if any one of you have. And, I'll just go ahead with some of the, questions which I see. And then I'll try to answer those questions. All right. So when we talk about, what are the resources are there for cloud security? This is one of the questions which we have received. So when we talk about this particular question, one of the things which I have told you that there are a lot of resources for cloud security, which exist, you will find many of them on our AWS digital training platform. We do conduct a lot of events around it, events like AWS Security Essentials, if you want, or if you are interested in a classroom training, we do have a security engineering on AWS, which is a 3 days full-fledged hands-on classroom training as well. A lot of these resources are available, and that is something which we can talk about, right? So that's one thing. Now, another question which I can see is, as a beginner, which path should we go for, all right? So when we talk about as a beginner, which path you want to go for, it's actually a choice which you need to make. And I'll tell you why. Don't depend on any advices. I can also advise you quite a lot of things, but then see, even if you are a beginner, the question is that you still might have some inclination, right? And that inclination might be from a different perspective. Like you might say that, okay, I am a person who is very much interested in, let's say, machine learning, right? So that could be one of the things which you can think about. Now, there could be another person who might say that, you know what, even though I'm a fresher, but then I, during my educational days, I have heard a lot about, let's say security, and I want to go through security. Someone can say that, okay, I am interested in big data technologies. Somebody might say, no, IoT or blockchain or machine learning. The thing is, it's your inclination. And I'll tell you something, you know, IPL is going on. We all might be aware of it. And some of you, I think, might be watching and following IPL as well, right? One thing which I can assure you is that why do you watch IPL? Why don't you don't watch those, homely serials which comes on TV? And there are people, even in my family, who watch those homely serials, right? And I don't watch it. Why? It doesn't cost me anything, but then I don't have any interest towards that area. So if I go ahead and tell you that, hey, you know what? Machine learning is growing. Go ahead and build your career in machine learning. Maybe you might not have that statistics and probability and mathematics, inclination where you might become successful in that. It's something like saying that, okay, you know what? What if Sachin Tendulkar would have practiced singing songs? Would he be able to, replace Lata Mangeshkar? I don't think so. So the first thing, the answer of this question is, you need to do a soul searching. You need to figure out what is it that you need? What is it which you want? And that, with that, you can actually think about it like, okay, if this is what I like to do, then let me test my waters a bit. So just try to see, okay, what all resources are available. Try to see what all things are required for it. For example, for machine learning, I believe a little bit of, college mathematics and statistics is important. And that is something which will help you to get started pretty quickly. Now, if you are a person who loves mathematics, then maybe machine learning might make sense for you. But then on the other hand, someone might be from a commerce background, right? And they might say that, okay, you know what? I was thinking about CA only because that's the only thing I've heard about it. But then they might be interested in banks as well, right? A lot of these banks, they are adopting or in the process of adopting the blockchain technology. Because I think that is one revolution which will come in the banking industry in a huge wave. And when it comes, there'll be a lot of banking professionals who would be required or IT professionals who would be required who would be from the blockchain background, right? So, if you ask someone, okay, what is a blockchain? They say Bitcoin. And that's the most absurd thing you can think about it because that's the only knowledge which people have. So you need to build up that knowledge, right? And then one thing you can do is, start off with the cloud practitioner, which is just the basics of the cloud and understand what cloud is all about. And then think about it in which line you need to go. You can directly choose a specialty learning path as well, right? So that's how I would answer that question. Okay. Next question, which I can see is, how can we get hands-on exposure? Okay, good question again. So folks, there are many resources which are available. One of the resources is definitely we all can go to a free tier account on AWS. And an AWS free tier account, the URL is aws.amazon.com/free. Simple URL, right? I'll just repeat it again, aws.amazon.com/free. Right? That's the URL. Now, what you need to do is when you go to that URL, you will find out what all is free, right? And there are some services which are free for 1 year. There are some services which are free for a trial period. And there are some services which are free lifelong. I want you to first understand what all services are free and at what level they are free. That's number one. Number two, you can create the free tier account over there. And then start practicing. That is one thing which you all can do. All right. So probably request Vitesh to type the URL as well for all of you. It is aws.amazon.com/free. That's the URL which you all can go through, and you can actually start your hands-on activity as well. Now, another thing which you all need to understand is that when we talk about hands-on exposures, right? So this free tier is one thing which can help you all with, right? But then there is another URL which I'll give it to you, and the URL is pretty simple. You don't even have to note it. You can just remember this. It is workshop.aws. Okay, workshops.aws. It's a plural word, workshops.aws. You have a lot of workshops with which you can practice. Now, here is another thing which I can tell you. Sometimes, what happens is a lot of students, they have asked me this question that how did you prepare for your interview when you were applying for Amazon? And again, let me tell you one thing is that we don't, usually look out for people who have that AWS knowledge. We respect people from any background. We just look at it, what they're bringing in to the table with us, right? What value add they would have, in our company. And when we talk about that, we basically come to know that you don't need to have only, AWS knowledge, but then there are many other things at which you might be good at, right? So, look at it this way. How did I prepare for myself? Because I was in a technical role, and technical role requires that knowledge. So I created the free tier account. That is great. But then there were many things which I wanted to try out, but then it was not under free tier. Now, the question is, how did I address that part? So one thing which I did is that if you go ahead and play around with any service, you can go ahead and see all their configurations, all their settings. You can click on next, 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 look at all those configuration options. But then instead of clicking on create or submit, I used to click on cancel. Why? Because I have seen all the options, right? Now I know what I will get, to see as an output, and that might require money. So I don't want to pay. If I don't want to pay, I can just click on cancel. Now, how will I see that whether after deployment, what happens, right? And this is something which you can go ahead through YouTube videos. So I used to figure out like, okay, this is a service. I have played around with it, but I have not deployed it. Why? Because it might cost me money. So now after deployment, what happens? I can find it on YouTube and I can see it. 10 videos of that service, if you see it on YouTube, trust me, you will believe that you have done it with your own hands. Okay, that's one way out. Now, second thing, there was a month when I was preparing for my interview. Okay, so I was in the interview stage and I was preparing for AWS services. And I figured out that there are some services which I have to deploy it, and it will cost me money as well. And I deployed it. It costed me money as well. But then I happily paid. I'll tell you in a year how much I had paid. Let's say I paid 24,000 or something. That is like 2,000 rupees a month. Okay, if you think about it. Now, you don't have to pay that money, but I did pay that money. The question is, that is my investment on myself. Just think about it. 2,000 rupees a month is nothing compared to where do all I go ahead and waste my money sometimes, right? Unfortunately part, but yes, true. And this is what I would, look at it at the big picture. You don't have to do that. If you are well, okay with the YouTube kind of a thing, go ahead and look at it over there. A lot of these demos are there. We, in fact, have a YouTube channel as well of Amazon Web Services. There are hundreds of videos over there. Just go ahead and subscribe to it. We have shown you demos. Just go to YouTube and search reInvent, okay? Or dive deep session on any service, and you will find all those videos. Anything which is from Amazon Web Services, you can consume them. And they have shown you those demonstrations, and you can play around with those things, right? So that's how I would answer probably that question. So any good place can you refer for AWS Solutions Architect Associate mock exams? Okay, so whenever you will go to our certification page, you do have a sample question. Okay, the practice tests are there, the sample questions. You can download it and you can have a look at it, like how, type of questions are being asked. It might be a set of 10 to 20 questions, but then that'll be good enough to give you an idea about it. See, I'll tell you one thing, is that when I was preparing for it, and there are a couple of exams where I couldn't clear it in first attempt. And that is okay. I mean, failing is not something which is a really bad thing. Okay. you can still hold your head high that you have attempted it, right? And then these couple of exams, I could clear it only in the second attempt. So I know that solutions architect professional exam, I failed it in my first attempt. Security engineering exam, the specialty, I failed it in the first attempt. So I had to prepare another, you know, couple of months to prepare for it, and then I could clear it. So that's what I would suggest you. Like, go ahead and work on your knowledge. Now, one good tip which I can give you is that any AWS exams, if you look at it, right, apart from the systems operations or SysOps exam, any other exam, we don't have any lab, you know, lab kind of a thing. We don't have any simulations. All the questions will be multiple choice questions only. So we are testing your theoretical knowledge, and that's where we'll judge you. So and one important tip along with it, what I have noticed, and I could be wrong, by the way, so please don't quote me anywhere, but then there is an FAQ section, okay, for each of the service. So if you go to aws.amazon.com/FAQ, FAQS, I guess, yeah, FAQS, that is the URL, aws.amazon.com/FAQS, you will find the FAQ for each of the services, right? So whatever exam you're preparing, create an Excel file, write all the services which are part of that exam, and go through the FAQ section of each of those services. Trust me, 10 to 15% of the exam, you're already prepared. Okay. And that's the good news for you. So that is, you know, these are some of the things which you can do. Definitely documentation goes a long, long way. Any question which we ask you is directly from the documentation. So if you are well-versed with the documentation, you are a person who creates notes and then go through these documentation, you can go through it. So the simple URL is docs.aws.amazon.com. Now, another thing which a lot of people ask me is that how much time it requires to prepare, right? See, it depends on you, what kind of learner you are, because some people have a longer learning curve, some people have a shorter learning curve. But then depending upon that, set aside a couple of hours a day, just 1 to 2 hours a day, and distribute it into multiple things. Like, don't say that, okay, in 2 hours, I will only read this documentation, because you will get bored. So divide it into 4 parts, the 2 hours divided by 4 parts, which means half an hour for one part. So what you can do in half an hour, you can actually decide like, okay, half an hour, I'll watch YouTube video. Half an hour, I'll read FAQ section. Half an hour, I'll go through documentation. And another half an hour, I'll practice on free tier account. Something like that. And then you don't have to do it for half an hour. Just do it for 25 minutes. Take a 5 minutes walk, come back, and then again, switch to the other thing. Now, I don't put a goal like I need to finish 100 pages within these 2 hours. I never do that, because you will never be able to keep pace up with that kind of a timetable. So create a timetable with your objective. Objective could be 25 minutes, I'll read this documentation. Whether I'm able to cover 100 pages or whether I'm able to cover only one page, that's okay. My goal is 25 minutes, I need to sit and go through this document. And while you do that, mobile phones are a big distractors. Okay, switch it off for 2 hours. Or get up early. If you are an early rising person like me, wake up early, sleep, go to bed early, and then wake up early. And then that morning time frame, don't look at WhatsApp. In fact, disable the notifications, okay? Don't go through any of these platforms. Just focus those 2 hours as a disturbance-free learning for you. Because morning time is good, which I believe, but then if you are a night person, like my wife, she is a night person, you can set up that in the late night as well, when you don't have that disturbance. But set aside those couple of hours for yourself, and that is the investment in yourself, which you're doing. And if you do that over a period of, let's say, 3 to 6 months, trust me, you'll be at a completely different level. But you got to do it religiously without any exceptions, be it a Saturday or a Sunday or a Holi, Diwali, Eid, Christmas, no matter what it is. You got to do it, even if it is your own marriage. Set aside 2 hours and go through it. Yeah, I might sound insane, but then that's a habit. You got to cultivate that habit, and those good habits will go a long, long way. All right. So please do that the right way. And over a period of time, you will see that change in yourself. So I believe I have tried to answer most of the questions which I thought of answering. And that's where I'll stop again. So what I would request you all is you know, to go ahead and talk about, think about it, like what you want to do in your life and then how you want to achieve it in your life, because that's the important thing, which you will see it, shaping your future. Having a plan is pretty important, and that's what you need to have, right? If you don't have a plan, then that's a bad thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, share one more time my contact details. Feel free to get in touch with me if you want. I'm sharing my contact details at the bottom. On LinkedIn, I do share, I think Vitesh is aware of it, and some of you who are connected with me on LinkedIn, you're aware of it. I only paste any new services or features or releases from AWS or some of our customers who basically are leveraging AWS and getting benefits out of it. So I, probably might be putting some case studies and use cases like that. So that is something where you can follow it as well. And I have sharing both my personal and official email as well. Feel free to get in touch with me if I can help you with any ways. With that note, thank you everyone for listening to me and being with me. Over to you, Vitesh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Saurabh, sir. On the behalf of AWS User Group Dehradun and UBS Cloud Security Alliance, I, Vitesh Sethi, would like to extend a very hearty vote of thanks for finding the time from your busy schedule and sharing the knowledge of AWS with us all. We look forward for such more interactions with you, sir. Thank you so much for your time.
Absolutely. My pleasure, Vitesh.
So guys, are you ready for the quiz? Can anyone confirm me in the chat if you guys can see my screen or not?
Yep, we can see yours.
Thank you, sir. So I'm sharing the URL. Please open this URL. Please log into this URL. One thing more, guys, please log in with your correct username so that it is easy for us to give the credits. Please enter the game pin as 8935893. I am pasting it in the chat. We are waiting for the couple of minutes. Please join fast. Guys, join fast. It's not loading. Okay. Please log in with this URL. It is working fine. You can log in with this URL. I have shared it on the screen. www.kahoot.it. The pin is 8935893. I'm pasting the pin in the chat box. This is the pin I'm sharing on the screen. I'm waiting for others to join. Please join fast. We will start in the next couple of minutes. Okay, we will be starting in the next 1 minute. Okay, so we will start the game. I'm telling you the rules. You need to see the questions from my screen and answer it to your device. You need to match the color code. Like for example, we have multiple choice question and we have four choices for each question. And for example, the correct choice is in blue and you need to answer it through your device, the blue one. Okay, everyone clear with the rules? Shall we start? Okay, we will starting. All the best, guys. So here is the first question. How many levels are there in AWS certifications portfolio? The options are 2 for red, 3 for blue, 4 for yellow, and 5 for green. You need to match the color code with your device. So the answer is 4. 5 people have corrected it. So here is the leaderboard. Aditya Yadav is on top. So here is the next question. Is there any prerequisite for writing AWS certifications? It is yes or no option. Yes for red and no for blue. Got it right. Rajit Paul is on top. Here is the next question. As per IDC FutureScape report, how many estimated global IT jobs will be left open by 2022? It's 70% for red, 50% for blue, 40% for yellow, and 30% for green. Oh, four got it right. Here is a leaderboard. Prakhar Modi is on top. Here is the fourth question. What is the recertification period for any AWS certification? Every 2 years for red, every 3 years for blue, every 4 years for yellow, and every 5 years for green. Hurry up, guys. So 11 got it right. The correct answer is every 3 years, as Saurav sir covered in the lecture. So here is the leaderboard. Rajit Paul is on top. The leaderboard changes drastically. Here is the last question. Can we give AWS certifications from home? No for red, yes for blue. Eighteen got it right. The answer is yes. We can give the AWS certification from home through online proctoring. So here is the podium. Swati is at number 3. Anchal Dobrial is at number 2. And Aditya Yadav is at number 3. Congratulations, guys. You have played it very well. I request all the top 3 participants to kindly share their contact details on my email ID. I'm writing my email ID on the chat window. All the top 3 participants, please share their contact details on my email IDs. The email ID is at the chat window. So thank you guys for joining the session. I hope you have learned a lot. And once again, thank you, Saurabh sir, for delivering the session very nicely. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Take care, folks.
Thank you all. Goodbye.